Riley Wetmore, the outstanding sophomore from Swan, Vermont, will take the opening faceoff with Stefan DaCosta. This hockey game is underway. That Collins getting in there to break up the play. Collins works toward the slot. Now Ellis outside the far circle in the slot. Backhander score! A seeing eye backhander that gets through Carr, and Merrimack takes a 1-0 lead. That was screening at its best, Mike. And he'll begin the attack left to right. Michael Shue had his pocket picked. Merrimack back. Here's a breakaway attempt and a score! Elliot Sheen will get the goal, and Merrimack takes a 2-0 lead. Allen will work the puck around the board. Zickert unable to keep it in. Merrimack with a chance. Here's a breakaway. Barton in all by himself, and he scores! Two shorthanded goals in one period for Merrimack. Chris Barton this time, and the Warriors take a 3-0 lead.
Dick Ferreira on the follow-up, pushes it to the right boards. Now quickly it comes up top to Ickert. Shot along the ice, deflected in, it's a goal. Ickert from the point, took the shot, and it changed directions, it was tipped in front. Lowell is on the board, Mike, at 8:35, 3-1 Merrimack. Edwards and Wetmore will look to set things up. 25 seconds to go on the Riverhawk power play. Wetmore in front, score! Valerani right out in front of the goal. Wetmore put it right on his stick. And the power play clicks for the Riverhawks.
Time will run out, and Merrimack will hang on. And we have some pushing and shoving here after the whistle.
Doesn't look like it'll amount to much, however. The Warriors will win 3-2, and they do end up holding Lowell to just one shot in the third period.
That is a season low for Merrimack in shots allowed.
Of course, it helped that they stayed out of the box in the third period. Lowell 1-for-4 on the power play tonight.
Mark Dennehy has just won his 50th game behind the Merrimack bench.